All right, hi guys, this is Fadli here from Zeppelin Co. And tonight we have Dominic, or OFTRT. Welcome to Zeppelin.
Thank you.
If you don't know, currently you are my favorite artist.
Wow.
That came here. You
but
know
I'm
why?
I'm only like the third, right?
Yeah, yeah, you know why?
Okay.
Because you bought muffins. Oh. Thank you. Thank you. All right, so personally, I've listened to some of your stuff. I find it quite transcendent and chill, you know, evokes a sense of discovery and wonder. I know this, like, I mean, how would you like describe your music, and how do you find yourself delving into this kind of genre?
It's a bit hard to describe. I guess you have to point me to like which, what tracks and which phase I am, because like I was exploring very different things.
Yes, that's exactly that's what I find interesting, because I was actually looking through your SoundCloud. It was back 4 years ago. So there were so many different kind of styles. So I was like, I personally do find myself like hard to pinpoint, like, hey, what kind of a musician are you? But if let's say you would wanna like tell your fans, like, how would you call yourself?
I guess like the keywords like ambient and chill and melancholic, but there's also like the harder stuff which I haven't released a lot, but like I have a lot of unreleased stuff that are like more dubstep or like house or things like that. Yeah, so
experimental?
Yeah, I guess experimental would cover it.
Would you call, do you see yourself, or do you call yourself like a zen person? From your music, I don't know, I get that vibe.
Yeah, definitely at times. Yeah, like that's definitely my mind when I produce the chiller stuff,
So do you meditate before that?
It's that usually like in the morning, so like it's super zen, like with coffee, and then like that's where I write.
Awesome. How long does it usually take to like come up with something, a zen track, I don't know, for example?
Like there's a track on Spotify, like it's called A Different Kind of Room. Like that took me like 1 day.
Ooh.
But that's like a super like rare instance of like the flow state, right? Like,
right.
Yeah, and yeah, that's super rare. And it's usually like when I don't really have anything in mind first, and like I go in without the expectation of having to do something good, and that's where like it usually happens.
Your tracks are really quite complex. You know, there's so many different kind of sounds and here and there. Is there any particular interesting recording that happens for some of the tracks? Like, do you go to the waterfall and take the waterfall sound or something like that? I don't know.
Yeah, like I do record, like take few recordings and stuff. And I've used it in some tracks, like things that I took from other countries or like Korea, stuff like that. Yeah, which is interesting to use insight, because like there's a very unique context for myself. Like no one knows it, but like when I hear it, it's like, oh, like only I have that narrative.
Do you have a plan to like tell that to your audience or something in an excerpt, maybe biography? I don't know.
I mean, unless like, I don't think so, like for most songs, but if it's like a sound art piece kind of, then yeah, then I think that would make sense to say, but if not, I think it would be better to not really give a fixed narrative to it.
Right. Okay. By the way, one of my favorite tracks that really got stuck in my head was Nice to Meet You. he didn't really play it just now, but you can check it out on his SoundCloud. Yeah.
That's a really old one.
Yeah. I like that one a lot. What made that song come about?
That period, like I just started going to electronic music and production, and I was listening to like a lot of Spaz Kid, No Such Thing, like I guess a bit of the happier stuff, like the more like
upbeat. It does sound like that. Yeah.
Fun and yeah. Then after I moved, I got over that whole phase. Mm-hmm,
Your recent one are more like ambient. Chill.
Yeah, it's more ambient and
All right. So, you mentioned earlier, during the production that you sometimes do not choose to release your music. Okay. Yeah. Because it feels outdated. Is it like a very difficult thing to do, or it's like, especially if let's say you put a lot of hours in your work and that kind, or it just feels like, you know, I don't like it, you're very strict with yourself, right, that kind of thing?
I guess it goes both ways. Like, it does, like, I shouldn't be too like perfectionist about it and release, but on the other hand, there's also like, you should only release things that like you really feel for it. If not, like, it just end up like hating it like 2 years later, which happens. It's a balance that I'm still trying to find. But like, yeah, so like, for example, like when, if this, like the just now the performance, if it comes out, like it might already be like, you know, like kind of backdated for me, then I'm like, why is that out, kind of thing. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I think it's a good philosophy to have to be like, you know, really something when you're only proud of your work. It is a balance kind of thing, you know. All the best for that, I guess. I forgot to ask, okay? What does OFTRT stand for? Does it like have a meaning or something?
Yeah, it came from the phrase of tracks and tykes. It was started with me and one of my close friends, like wanted to be like a electronic duo.
Oh, nice.
Then we just saw this phrase and we're like, okay, let's use this. But I mean, in the end, he didn't do music already, lah. So like, I just said, like, let me take the name, but then like, I kind of shortened it because thought it was a bit long.
Oh, okay. So what was the longer name? Do you remember?
Of Tracks and Tykes.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
right,
so I shortened it OFTRT.
That's nice. Okay, last question. Okay, what's your advice for those who are like interested to do music like you? You know, more specifically, maybe looking back, like with the experience that you have now, what would you have done differently that could have helped you start off better? Yeah.
Good question.
Yeah.
I guess my advice would be to really try everything and also like really take in a lot of different kinds of music. And I guess not to be too, I guess be patient in like in terms of like getting out there to like just, you know, spend a few years just to like find your sound, like experiment, like, and don't look at like, you know, other things like following and stuff. Yeah, I guess that would be it.
Okay. Maybe just one more question. that got me interested in a bit. Like, for your very, very first song, okay, now talking about, you know, balancing between what you're proud of and, you know, starting out, I feel, what would be like, how was it like releasing your first song? You know, how long did it take from when you're starting out and finding that, okay, I'm going to release it, like, yo, you know?
I guess I would consider, like, two different first songs. Like, they are like, the super drafty ones that are only, like, kind of, like, five friends here. And then there's the first, which is, like, officially on a platform and, like, I share it. But let's say the official one, the first. I guess it feels like any release. Like, I don't think it really ever changes. Like, it's exciting and scary. Yeah. It's always the case, I feel.
That's cool. All right. So thanks for being us here today. That was Dominic. You can find him on Spotify and SoundCloud. Is there a particular maybe streaming platform that you prefer? Because I do find like some of your songs are here.
Yeah,
a
bit quite here, like there. Scattered.
Yeah, like YouTube also have some.
Maybe Spotify first.
Spotify, yeah. All right. check him out on Spotify. You can find it. It's OFTRT.
Yeah.
Yes. All right. Special thanks to the camera crew from Modular House Production. Of course, the sound crew as well. And do check them out. You can find Dom's full performance at their YouTube channel. That's all for now. And we'll see you guys soon at Zeppelin Co. Thank you.
Thank you.